In this question, it says that 63 is written as a product of 5 distinct integers. So let's factorize it. 63 is 7, 9, so 63. So 3, 3, 7. So obviously, we just have used up 3 digits, like 3 numbers, and you need 5 distinct numbers. So maybe you could have used 1 and 1. But then we can't use the same number twice. Here we have already used it twice. So the only way we could actually work out a way is if we make one of these negative, because it does not say anywhere that it's a product of 5 positive integers anywhere. So what we do is we make 1, 3 negative and we make one of the ones negative. So negative 3 times 3 times 7 ones and minus 1 here. These are the 5 numbers that we have. Now, as we can see, one of these two would always repeat and one of these two will always repeat if I keep positives. So there is actually no other way in which we can write down 63, okay, as a product of 5 distinct numbers, because we need to focus on the word distinct. That's important. For example, if you think of doing 3, 3, minus 7, 1, minus 1, there's a problem with this. And now if I do another minus 3, then the overall product becomes negative. Now to adjust that, I have to put another one. Again, these two now become equal. So that's not possible. So there is only one way. So it's saying n is the sum of these 5 integers. So the sum of these 5 integers is 3 and 3 cancel, negative 3 cancel out, 1 and minus 1 cancel out. The sum is 7. They are saying, what is the sum of all possible values of n? So n has only one possibility, that's 7 itself. So sum of the all possible values of n will be 7 only. So this was a theta question. So you write the answer as 7.